Relief for people in Lee County. Lee County Solid Waste resumed recycling and yard waste collection today.
Wake News reporter Amy Gallo is at the debris drop-off site now, and Amy, crews have been out clearing hurricane debris for the last week. Why did recycling and regular yard waste get put on the back burner?
Well, last week's focus was wet waste, or food waste as we all know it, and that was due to a lot of homes losing power during Hurricane Milton, which resulted in a lot of food waste being piled up on the side of the road, which is a health risk and attracts vermin. So the county's main focus was that, and now that they're done with it, they're moving on and switching gears. Waste collection. It's not usually something you think about.
Normally, if we do our job right, we're sort of invisible to people. People don't know that we're out there getting it done. But with a hurricane, we become very visible.
In places like this neighborhood, just off McGregor Boulevard, where Karen Jolving's debris pile once stood tall.
It was probably 6 feet long or 8 feet maybe, and then it was piled high with cupboards and some furniture. They started yesterday at 6 a.m, Sunday morning. And then they came and got the rest early this morning.
County crews have been hard at work removing debris since last week.
After the storm, there were tens of thousands of homes without power, and the food went bad in their refrigerators and freezers. So that created a large amount of food at the street, which is a health hazard.
And now that that's been taken care of, the county resumed recycling and yard waste collection on Monday.
We're picking up garbage, we're picking up recycling, and picking up vegetation all week long and for the foreseeable future.
And you can help make it easier.
The most important thing that I can tell the residents and the citizens is that great collection starts with them separating the material and making sure they put those things out, not near a mailbox, not near a power pole or anything like that. So it helps us get the job done a lot quicker.
Now, for more information on what you should or shouldn't do when you are sorting out your debris piles, you can head to winknews.com. I have a link posted for you with all of that information, as well as information as to where you can find your nearest debris drop-off site, like the one behind me here, so you can drop off the debris yourself if you choose to. Live in Fort Myers, Amy Gallo, Wink News.
All right, Amy, thank you. The city of Sanibel.